faith you're keeping something a secret from me. Just tell me what it is.
Hi. I didn't know you were here.
Mom, what's going on? Why are you so upset?
Faith, could you give us a minute, please?
Sure.
Did something happen? Is Liberty okay?
Yeah, I just saw Liberty at the police station, actually. She's fine. Parker, I don't want you to panic, okay?
Just tell me what it is, Mom.
Gabriel changed his story. He said he lied about Craig trying to kill him.
Are you serious? You told the truth?
It may not be the truth, but your father bought it, so Craig's off the hook. For the attempted murder, not for the other charges, of course.
Well, so what happens now?
I don't know. Maybe nothing. Or the DA might decide to press charges against you. There's no way to know right now. But honey, don't worry, okay? Because whatever happens, everything's gonna be all right. I promise you that.
Yeah, okay, whatever.
Just don't give up hope, okay?
No, seriously, Mom, I'm so sick of this, okay? I just want it to be over, and I honestly don't care how it ends,
okay? You have to care.
Hey, did you find Carly?
Yeah.
It didn't go so well, huh?
That's an understatement.
Well, can I buy you a cup of coffee?
Yeah, sure, thanks. Margo?
Wait. I know what you're gonna say. Now that Gabriel has dropped the charges against Craig, how do things stack up for Parker, huh?
I couldn't have asked it any better myself.
Yeah.
Answer?
Here's what I think happened that night. Parker and Gabriel got into a fight. Parker threw a punch. Gabriel slipped, fell, knocked himself unconscious. And then the fire started. And then Gabriel ended up in ICU.
Parker had nothing to do with setting that fire.
I know. And Gabriel has made a full recovery, so that's 2 points in Parker's favor. However, the DA is still sitting on the original assault charges.
Yeah, and it's liable to get more attention now that Craig's been cleared of those assault charges.
Except I'm going to recommend that it all be dropped. In my mind, it's not worth pursuing.
So it's over?
Yep. How do you like my answer?
Oh, it's the sweetest thing I've heard in weeks. I know a couple other people are going to think so, too. You made one hell of a
get
cup of coffee,
here,
you know
shit.
That, Chief?
I just feel like the ground isn't solid under your feet.
I never know what's gonna happen next, unless it's something bad.
But you can't give up. Because if you do, all the wrong people win. You were victimized here. Don't forget that. And now you could face assault charges? It's just not right.
I did throw the punch at Gabriel, man.
I don't care. He fell. You did not knock him out.
I don't think that's how the police are gonna see it, okay?
I don't care how the police see it. And I'm gonna stand by you and stick by you, and we're gonna get through this. You hear me?
Hey, I just...
I'm talking to Parker right now, Dad.
I'm sorry, I'm gonna interrupt you, because I think this is something you both are gonna want to hear.
Dad, what's going on?
It's over. You're not gonna be prosecuted.
Are you kidding?
Margo just told me herself it's official.
Dad, that's awesome,
right?
Thank you.
What happened?
I'm not going to be charged with anything.
That's great.
Hey, why don't the two of you go someplace and celebrate? It's on me.
Okay, are the two of you going to be okay here?
Yeah, I think so. Go, have fun. You're awfully quiet.
I'm thinking.
Thinking about what? We should be celebrating too? Hey, I'm all for it. Carly, you ought to be thrilled. Parker's safe. This is what we wanted. We can finally put this behind us and move on.
Maybe you can do that, Jack. But I can't.
We got what we wanted, Carly. You, me, and Parker.
All's well that ends well. Is that it? You would think that.
Look, I realize that for some reason you consider everything I did on this case a betrayal.
For some reason? You're more interested in being a cop than you were in being a father.
That's your take on it. I don't see it that way. But obviously that's the way you feel, so I've got to accept it.
Oh, that's
big of you. Thank you.
Hey, wait a minute. Why are we fighting, Carly? Every issue between us since the day of that fire has been settled.
Doesn't feel settled to me.
Gabriel told the truth. And Parker didn't suffer as a result. Which is exactly what we were all after.
Oh, you see, that's where we disagree. Just on that last little part. Because you are after your precious truth.
Well, hey, listen, it worked out, didn't it? Carly, the truth will set you free, as much as you hate to admit that.
Oh, well, it's easy to say that now after the fact. You didn't know how it was going to turn out.
I had faith.
You had luck.
Oh, I see. So nothing I did had any bearing on the outcome, right? My principles, my hard work, they were all pointless. Is that the message here?
Your hard work could just as easily have sent my son to jail.
Your son. Your son. What is that supposed to mean?
I think you know exactly what it means. You would not have put Parker's future at risk if he was really yours.
I cannot believe you just said that to me. I am Parker's father. Yeah, Hal was Parker's biological father, but I'm his father in all the ways that count. You even thought that too, Carly. Does this mean you don't believe that anymore?
All I'm saying is that if it were Sage who'd been in trouble, you would have done anything to protect her.
Including bend the law. Maybe break it.
You wouldn't have thought about the law or ethics or any of that.
Okay, you see this? Carly, this is a badge I've been carrying around with me for most of my life. It means that I have the responsibility to uphold that law.
What about your responsibility to your family? To Parker? You promised Hal you would always protect him.
Yeah, I also have a conscience, Carly. And I can't ignore the facts in a case just because I don't like them.
You know, you talk about having a conscience. But honestly, I don't know if I believe that.
You cannot be serious.
A father with a conscience protects his son. That's what he does. Forget the right thing. That's a fucking thing.
And where does right slide into wrong for you? Or doesn't that matter? I really want you to explain that to me. Because you say the family is the most important thing to you. That protecting your kids is the most important thing to you.
That's right.
Okay, at what cost? Lying? Stealing evidence? Destroying evidence? How is that a model for your son or daughter?
I never said I was a saint.
I don't expect you to be one.
Oh, bull. You keep track of all my mistakes. You always have. I'm surprised you don't jot down my sins in your little notebook.
That's not fair.
And you know why I don't always do the right thing, Jack? Because I'm not always a good person. I can admit that. You're not always a good person either, but you can't admit it.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means you're a liar and a hypocrite. That's what it means.
Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go before this gets any ugly.
Why? What's the matter, Jack? You like the truth, just not this truth? That you bend the rules when it suits you? That you say one thing, that you do another?
What? Time out. Is this about this Holden and Molly thing? Because if you think that I would help Molly get away with killing a man, you're wrong, Carly.
Stop telling me I'm wrong. I am so sick of hearing those words come out of your mouth. When I hear them, I just...
What? Tune me out?
Do you remember when Brad died? You said that was a life-altering moment for you. You promised that you were going to change, that you were going to stop being so self-righteous and judgmental.
Yeah, I remember.
What happened to that promise, Jack? Because you're still measuring everybody else by how right you are. How is that different than you've always been? Face it, Jack. You killed your own brother and it didn't change you a bit.